Get him. Oh, this is weak. Come on. Wow. What's going on, everybody? It's Monkey Farm. We're back with some more Ark Survival Evolved here on the Pooping Evolved server, Season 3. We're over at the treehouse, the PvP treehouse. We just did some PvP games last episode, so if you missed that, definitely check it out. We had a lot of fun. We did a handful of different games. Mostly it was just like free, you know, free-for-all, just last man standing, see if you can knock out everybody. We were doing Trank Darts. We also did a couple rounds with using clubs to knock out people, so we weren't using crossbows or anything. I do want to still try some slingshots, but nobody had a like a higher level slingshot, because a primitive slingshot would just take way too long to knock anybody out. So we wanted to see if we could find some higher level blueprints for slingshots. So I'm probably going to be doing a lot more to the treehouse as well, like building out the second level. If you can see up here, like I can make a level out of all of that stuff to give it more hiding spaces, more places to run around and stuff like that. It was quite. We had four people on, and it was pretty fun. But I think adding more levels will even make it more fun. So we'll be doing that at some point too. I still have to finish the bridge over here. But today what we're gonna do is we're gonna do some Quetzal action. We're gonna go, if you remember last season, season 2, that was the one where I built the giant skull base right up the river there. If you didn't check any of that out, check out that whole playlist. But at the very end of the season, right before we reset the map, I had been breeding my high-level Quetzals, and I had some really high-level ones. And right before we reset, I had a male and a female level 203 hatched Quetzals, and those were super awesome. So what I think I want to do, I did upload them to the obelisk. But I don't think I want to just download them and bring them into the map. I think what I'm going to do is download them and breed them and then re-upload them. You know, so because I don't want to bring them onto the map because I didn't really make them here, so to speak. I made them in season 2. But I do want to get an egg from them, and then we can hatch the eggs. And, of course, you know, breed them with other high-level Quetzals we have here, or... I just made it to level 80 as well, so we can make a Quetzal platform saddle now too. So if we find a really high level Quetzal out somewhere, we can tame it, you know, with the a Quetzal, an air trap, or whatever you want to call the big contraption you put on the back of the Quetzal. So I think what I need to do, well, I don't have any of the machinery, so I'm gonna have to build all that stuff. But why don't we just go download our two animals? I've never done downloaded anything, so I don't really know. I'm pretty sure it's easy. By the way, this is full speed. this is why I want to continue hatching my high level Quetzals, because they were just amazing. They were super fast. Like we need a speed Quetzal, and we need an attack, you know, a fighting Quetzal. And then we also need a weight Quetzal. So, you know, whatever, I don't know. We'll hatch an egg. Maybe we'll get triplets and we'll get one of each and we won't even have to worry about it. But, oh, this is so slow. Can you believe how slow this is? Like, that's like full speed. And yeah, this was a level 12 and it's up to level, what, 54? So it's pretty ridiculous. It's time, like, I haven't spent any time getting really high level animals because I've been building the treehouse pretty much since we started this season, and just excited to get some higher level animals. And since I had just started breeding, you know, getting high level Quetzal eggs and breeding them in last season, I wanted to continue that. And I'm pretty sure that somebody on the server has like a 120 or even higher level here on this season. So it'd be really cool to see if we can breed our high level Quetzals with some of the other high level ones on the season 3 server, and maybe we'll get some better stats, you know, that we didn't have last season. So that should be pretty cool too. So I think what I'm gonna do, I don't know if I'm gonna bring them back. I guess I should bring them back to the base and breed them, because I won't want to re-upload them to the obelisk until their cooldown period happens or whatever. Because if one egg doesn't turn out okay, why am I getting so much lag around here? Must be somebody's big base around here. Yeah, I'm getting like super lag. Somebody's got a lot of animals around here, I think. Must be the softest base or something. Anyway, yeah, it's like super weird. Okay. Well, let's get into tribute terminal. Summon Broodmother, no. How do I do this? Is it transmit arc data? Okay, so there's all my stuff. Download creatures data, right? Upload, must be. Okay, so I've got Fuddrucker and Feathermucker. great names. So what I just need to download Dino. Right? And then download Dino. Is it done? Oh, there's Fuddrucker. Ooh, and there's Feathermucker. Nice. And they're mate boosted. How beautiful. I'm not going to level them up because... Wait, 257? What is this? 257? Oh, did I can't remember. Did I use this guy? I guess I took him out last season and leveled him up a little bit. And then I had hatched this one right before we reset. So I was using Feathermucker. Yeah, that was like right before the end. Check out this guy's stats. So let's see. Movement speed 290. I did have one, I think, that was level 300 movement speed, but he also has melee of 638, which is pretty decent. His health wasn't anything spectacular or anything. But let's, they're both following me. Okay. That's good. So let's fly these guys back to the base and do a little breeding action. And then, they're so fast. Like, I can't even go fast enough. All right, we're back. We already had some chaos. Of course, like, a raptor spawned in here or jumped down the cliff on us or something right when we landed, and of course, and yeah, and this is what happened. All this following and unfollowing, and I don't have saddles for all these guys yet. I didn't download any saddles, so yeah, maybe I should make some new saddles. But let's get an egg out of these guys first real quick. And then we can take them back to the obelisk, or what is going on? I guess it's hot here. Yeah, okay. So let's enable wandering and and I'm going to have to do some whistling so they don't run away, but who's the female? Let's see. She is the female, so the egg should be coming out of this one over here. All right, I'll be back once the egg... I'm not going to make you listen to the whistling, so we'll be back once we have an egg. There we go. Look at that. We got it. All right, so let's get these guys to disable wandering real quick so we don't lose them. And I forget, what is the cooldown time? Enable wandering. Oh, yeah, the male can mate at any time, and we have 19 hours until Feathermucker can mate again. All right, so we're going to hold the egg, and what we're going to have to do, we're going to have to throw down some air conditioners. I was thinking of doing it back here because we have this open space. The only spot I don't want to block is this backside where I can load stuff into these chests, but this is not our permanent hut anyway. So I think it doesn't really matter. We can just build a little egg hut here with some air conditioners. I don't even think it really needs to be enclosed. I think the air conditioners do more than enough to take care of the hatching temperature and everything. And I'm also going to need to make a generator so that we can turn them on and power them. So let me check out what I need here. I think we make some of that stuff in the fabricator. Let's see. We need air do I have air conditioners? No, I don't. Okay, so we've got air conditioners. Air conditioner, that takes some electronics, polymer, crystal. I've got the metal. And then, so if I want to make, like, let's say, I probably only need three or four of those. And then I need a generator, which I think, do I make here as well? Yeah, just need some electronics for that. Okay, so I am going to check my inventories and stuff. I think I have, I've got a lot of metal in here somewhere. I've been using it a lot. Yeah, I've got a couple hundred here and a couple hundred in there. So I know I've got enough metal. I'm going to make some. I think I have some cementing paste and stuff too. So I am going to go ahead and make that stuff and we'll be back. All right, we're back. I went up to the volcano, grabbed some metal, made our air conditioners, and I need to also, let's see, make a little hut back here. I should have more ceilings than this. Why do I only have two? Let's see. Are they in here? Thought I had more than that. Got foundations. Maybe I'll have to make a few more. I'm not sure. Let's go back here. Let's see what we can do here. I think a 2x2 should be more than enough, and we'll just leave one of the doors open in the back. Good, everything fits. And nice. All right. And we'll just leave one of these open, and we'll leave like this thing open right here. Let's see. Did I grab some walls? Yes. This, and I guess I'll make it too high. Why not? Let's see, I put these. Yeah, actually, you know what I could do? I could just put these right here and have the generator. Generator, like, right here. Let's see. So I'll leave that spot empty and then move this back here. Whoops. Put another one here. Put one right here. And the fourth one right here. All right, so we'll throw our eggs right in the middle there, and that should work pretty well. The generator, I don't remember how big that thing is. Did I grab it? Yes. It's going to be noisy, but we're only going to be running it while... can I rotate this or what? What's the deal? Wow, this is bigger than I thought. why don't I just throw this down here? Outside. This is all temporary kind of anyway. I guess I need an outlet too. I forgot, huh? Because it's not powered. I'm going to have to... Yeah, I forgot about that part. And then, yeah, that'll be all we need. I think the temperature is fine. I don't think we'll need ceilings or anything. Let's see. What is it called? An outlet? I don't even think I bought it yet. What is the electrical outlet? I need straight electrical cable. Okay. Outlet... let's see. Hopefully I have everything I need for it. Oh, I just need wood. Okay. So we're good there. Anyway, so these things should be powered once I turn it on. I'm going to have to grab a couple cans of gas or gallons or whatever they call these things. And we can throw that egg down and it'll take a while to hatch. It's probably going to take an hour. Obviously, we're not going to be able to grow the whole thing up today. It's going to take a long time, but let's go check. These things should be powered. Yes, they're all powered. And it is time. Where is our beautiful little Quetzal egg? So, number 9. Oh, wait. I don't want to do that. That is... I could accidentally eat it. I know I'd probably eat it, right? Okay, so we just want to drop that. And there's our beautiful egg and everything. Is everything good? The temperature? Yes, it's incubating. Sweet. All right, so this is going to take a while. So we'll be back, and hopefully we'll get like twins or triplets. That would be so sweet. So we would have our whole new group of... hopefully they're all going to come out at least level 203, since both parents, I think, are exactly the same. We should have... I don't see any reason why we wouldn't have, you know, the offspring right in that level. So, yeah. All right, we'll be back. All right, we are back. Our egg is almost ready. And we had a little problem. The temperature got really hot for a little bit. And we did lose a little bit of egg health, but not too much. So it shouldn't affect anything. So I added a couple more air conditioners. I didn't realize, I forgot, I put one in the corner. So I guess I'll have to add one over here and maybe in that corner just to make it look symmetrical, but not a big deal. But I'm going to throw down another feeding trough, I guess. I guess I'll put it outside right here. So that whenever we have our animals hatch, we can bring them out here and let them grow up. Then what I'm going to do, let's see... I'm going to take maybe this guy right here. I'm going to call over some tough guys. And what I'll do is I'll put this trike in peaceful mode. Let's see how... Let me get like you. Let's see, fangs. And we'll get you. All these guys are following fangs, I think. All right, we'll get all these tough guys over here to follow Barrington, I guess. And then we'll put Barrington in peaceful mode over here. And then all these guys right here will protect our babies when they hatch. I think I have too many animals following that guy. I think I'll change that. I'll just have a couple have the raptors or something protect the babies as they grow up, because I'm not going to sit here for 20 hours and watch them. But we are almost ready to hatch. Oh, what did we get? We just got one. All right, let's do a little imprint. Baby. I'll worry about naming it and all of that stuff later. All right, so let's get it to follow us out here. Obviously, it can't grow up inside there. Baby. Follow me, dude, over here. Oh, I didn't check. Is it a male or female? We have a male level 203. Stats are all the same, I guess. Weight 1328, that's pretty good. Stamina's pretty good. Melee, I think that looks a little low. What? I'll go check the one that I haven't leveled up at all and see what the base melee is for that one. That seems a little low. I would think it would be in the 300s, but we'll see. All right, so we only got one, but that's okay. We can breed them again, or breed them with another high-level Quetz on the server here. Alright, so let's get him over here. Man, this place is a mess. I need to start building some animal huts. Because every time we have a... we get like a Dillo that spawns right here, and everybody runs over and kills it. So it's pretty crazy. But, alright, so let's get this guy to stop following. And just as a reminder, you gotta disable wandering as well, or they'll start flying away without you or something like that. So we don't need this anymore. We can shut that off. How much gas did we use? Let's see, 9. I think we used 4 or 5 gas or something like that. I don't know. Anyway, so we're going to have to keep feeding this guy until he... Whoa. Yeah, I didn't realize he was out of food already. Yeah, so we're going to have to keep feeding this guy and until he's an adolescent or a juvenile or whatever is next. And then we will have him fully grown. All right. Well, that is going to be it for today. So make sure you check back and see our fully grown baby next episode. And that will be it. All right. We'll see you all later.